Whatever else Jimmy Carter is or will be, he is a gracious guest with a knack for putting folks at ease. He came in the door a stranger and left a friend, Ed Thompson told me. And whether they sought Carter's warmth or just a chance to see the president, any president, the folks of Clinton gathered early to see him. They were not disappointed. Shortly before 8 a.m., Carter came out to press the flesh of those who waited for hours in the bone-chilling cold. All around me, women were saying, "I don't believe it," as they realized at last they were coming face to face with the president of the people. After chatting with the crowd, Carter said his goodbyes, put on a tie, and he was off to Charleston, West Virginia. Two of the Thompson kids were late to school, but the president had taken care of that.
Two teacher from Jimmy Carter.
Turn it this way.
Please excuse Jane from being late. She had a guest in her home.
Inside, the Thompsons talked about the visit.
He took off his jacket and sat down, and that's it. Then that's it. He just went in and sat down and crossed the legs, and that was it. You made the introductions, and away you went. One word borrowed another, and you went from one subject to another, and that's it.
Just a very relaxed evening. It really was. I mean it. I was just so delighted because I said, I was more afraid of you people and nervous about you people instead of him.
Will Clinton and will the Thompson ever be the same? Gunnar Thompson was asked that precise question, and he seemed to sum it up when he said, "Will you be interviewing me a year from now?" From the town that hosted the president, this is Ron Golubin, News 5 in Clinton.